The Jake Brake is a simple hydromechanical device adaptable to most high-performance diesel engines sold today. Its rugged design and few moving parts make it ideally suited to heavy-duty vehicle use. The Jake Brake is an engine retarding system that uses the diesel power plant itself to slow the vehicle. The retarder is not a replacement for the service brakes. It is a supplemental braking device completely under driver control that converts a power-producing diesel engine into a power-absorbing mechanism. The Jake Brake modifies the operation of the exhaust valves and only operates when the engine is in a no-fuel mode. To illustrate how a Jake Brake works, let's look at engine operation without a brake. We'll use one cylinder as an example. The intake valve is opened and air is pulled into the cylinder. The air is compressed to between 500 and 1,000 PSI. Fuel is injected and combustion occurs, increasing temperature and pressure to nearly 1,500 PSI. Pressure from the expanded gases of combustion drives the piston down, producing power to turn the crankshaft and provide energy through the drivetrain to push the vehicle forward. The upward motion of the piston on the return stroke forces the exhaust gases out of the cylinder, completing the cycle. But something very different happens with a Jake Brake installed. The key is a hydraulically actuated slave piston mounted over the exhaust valve. There is no change in the intake cycle, and the compression stroke starts out the same. But just before the piston reaches top dead center, the hydraulically operated slave piston opens the exhaust valve, and the compressed air, representing potential energy, is released through the exhaust system. By venting the energy of the compressed air, no positive power is exerted on the piston. It has been eliminated. This is the first step in providing engine retarding. However, some source of energy is needed to return the piston to its bottom position. This energy is derived from the forward momentum of the vehicle and is the second step in generating the total retarding effect of the Jake Brake. Let's look at the cycle again from a different viewpoint. When the driver steps on the throttle, fuel is injected and combustion provides power through the drivetrain to move the vehicle forward. With the Jake Brake on, the retarder is energized when the driver removes his foot from the throttle, releasing the compressed air without producing power. Energy required to move the pistons through their normal cycle is now derived from the vehicle's forward motion instead of engine combustion. Now, instead of producing power, the diesel's function has been reversed to an energy-absorbing air compressor. A strong retarding force, slowing power, occurs as the pistons use up the energy of the truck's forward motion to compress air taken into the cylinder. Here's how the Jake Brake works hydraulically. The main components are the slave piston and the master piston. They are fabricated from alloy steel and have no internal parts. The slave piston is mounted over the exhaust valve. The solenoid and control valves manage the flow of engine oil, which serves as the Jake Brake's hydraulic fluid. Both of these components contain a number of internal working parts. Oil to the brake housing is supplied by the engine oil pump. In the deactivated position, oil is prevented from entering the housing by the solenoid's internal mechanical seal and center O-ring. The valve also contains a screen to filter out any large particles carried up by the engine oil. When the brake is activated, the electric coil pulls the disc of the solenoid down against the pin and ball check, permitting oil to bypass the mechanical stop and fill the passage to the control valve. This exerts sufficient force to raise the valve and index with the high pressure passage and unseat the ball check. Engine oil then fills the passage between the slave and master pistons, and moves the master piston down against the injector pushrod, or in some engines, the exhaust pushrod of an alternate cylinder. The pushrod is moved up against the master piston by camshaft rotation, creating sufficient pressure to move the ball check down, creating a closed hydraulic system between the slave and master piston. The pressure of the entrapped oil increases, providing sufficient force to move the slave piston down and open the exhaust valve just before the piston reaches top dead center. This releases the compressed air representing potential energy. As explained earlier, the removal of this power-producing energy and its replacement by energy absorbed from the vehicle's forward momentum provides the slowing power of the Jake Brake compression engine retarder. This sequence is repeated whenever the driver has the dash switch in the on position, the clutch engaged, and removes his foot from the throttle. When the driver steps back on the throttle to accelerate, the brake is de-energized and shut down. The high-pressure oil is forced out of the housing and flows back into the engine oil supply. The low-pressure oil flows back through the housing and is returned to the engine oil supply through a passage in the base of the solenoid valve. Now let's look at the driver controls for the Jake brake. The on-off dash switch and progressive braking switch are mounted on the control console. The clutch and throttle switches are positioned so as not to interfere with driver operation. Normally, the dash switch is left in the on position when the vehicle is in use. Most installations include a progressive braking switch. The three-position model shown permits specific levels of retarding power to meet changing road conditions. For example, in some six-cylinder engines, 2, 4, or 6-cylinder braking can be selected. Other installations incorporate all functions in one switch. The Jake brake is either off or in the low or high position. The type used depends on the engine make in the vehicle. The remaining two switches are activated whenever the driver has his foot off the throttle and the clutch fully engaged. Once turned on, the system is fully operational whenever the vehicle is in a no-fuel mode and the driveline is engaged. Depending on the weight of the load, the driver need only select the amount of braking required. This, of course, comes with experience. Controls for automatic transmissions vary somewhat. The Jake Brake is a full-time working partner in providing vehicle control.